kicks in.
No.
Go for it, Nick. Take it away.
Not Patriot, so.
Take it away, Nick. We're
allowed them now. Yeah, so today we're going out for the first day of the Congressional Cup. Just trying to learn as much as we can, do our best races, and not have any bad results on the board. Yeah. So with the round robin today, we're going to verse every other competitor in the regatta once, and if you get a point, win, you get 1 point. If you get a loss, you get 0 points for that. And at the end of the round robins, the teams with the highest points, the top four, will go through to the semis. Our strategy today is to just follow the team processes. So we just want to go through everything we normally do, not try to change anything up too drastically. Have good comms and have good fun.
Put it there, son.
Shake each other.
Well done, Bradley. Best luck, man.
Hey, Scotty.
Yes, ma'am.
Ready for today?
Very ready. Yeah, boys are pumped. Day one Con Cup, here we go.
All right, any tips for the youngsters?
Oh, keep it moving. I think it's going to be a lighter day, and keep it cool. It's a long week. Every race counts, but you know, just got to incrementally get a little better and have a good time.
Good work. Go Kiwis.
All righty. Thanks, Ellen.
Thank you.
See you guys. Good luck.
Cheers. Have a good one.
See you out there.
See you soon.
You good too, huh?
Yeah, I'm good.
It's a big one for.
So Larry,
yep.
What advice did you give your team this morning?
Lead at the start. Cover.
Watch those Kiwis.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right, we've got half Kiwis on our team. Here our good luck charm.
25 seconds to go to the start. The Kiwis look as though they'll get a start out of this at the PNN, running away from Doc Hammer, who's in a bit of dirty air right now. All five matches, Mary, are now on the race course. Let's get an update of who's who, what's what, and who's in the lead so far.
Well, I'm seeing that Nick took the left. He liked the left, and he was around the top mark first, and he's been keeping his lead. And it looks like that Nick and Nick are neck and neck.
Oh, you coming took my line. That's brilliant. Nick and Nick
coming
are neck
on
and
down
neck
the course, and they're keeping that race right there a little exciting as well.
He's number 10, and that's Nick Egnot-Johnson. One more length to go. Flight number one. Match number one from New Zealand goes to Nick Egnot-Johnson. Doesn't matter how you start, it matters how you finish. Kiwis take first blood.
The smile on your face lets me know that you leave me. And the truth in your eyes, saying you'll never leave me.
Hey, Nick. Nick.
Yeah, he wants us to come over there.
Oh, yeah, pretty tidy start, I think. Just kept it clean, sailed the ships up the course.
Yeah, started simple. Boat speed was the key we were taking into that race.
Yeah.
And I think we achieved that.
Yeah.
So did a bit fast around the track, sailed to the ships we wanted to, and we just sort of backed our course and came away with a win.
Chipping away at it.
A few more to go.
Let's keep chipping. Yeah, I think so.
Did she want it in 30 seconds or she wanted it?
I think she wanted it in like, takes 30 seconds. Did you want it to take 30 seconds? Yeah.
She wants us to start now.
Do you want us to start now? Oh, okay.
Oh, okay, yeah. Sweet.
The smile on your face, let me know that you need me.
Hey, there is a karaoke in the chat.
Is there?
Yeah.
Oh,
coming into the finish, Egnot-Johnson, we believe he still has, yeah, he's still got a penalty to undertake. So the penalty he has to do is he has to take the spinnaker down, get the head of the spinnaker below the boom, and turn, go through head to wind. So we should see the spinnaker come right down very shortly. Here it comes, spinnaker coming down. He has to now Spinnaker's down, he's going to go around the finish mark, that buoy, and he's going to get down and try and finish, and here comes Williams.
Now, to my eye, that might have been a mistake. Instead of spinning the penalty turn right on the line, he sailed an extra length and a half to do it around the pin. That opens the door up for Williams. That's his spinnaker coming in from behind. Williams has pace. Egnot-Johnson puts his bow down. Does he have enough room to get it? Will he win the match? The answer, folks, I believe is yes. Yes, he's done it. Nick Egnot-Johnson, his mother Leslie, watching from New Zealand live. Late at night down there, just seen her son win against six-time world champion Ian Williams. What a match. Again, just to bring you up to speed, it's Nick Egnot-Johnson.
His camera was off.
And Maxime Mensel from France. And there's the dial-up, folks. Thanks, guys. And we're back.
Egnot-Johnson following him. We're coming down to 1:20. Here they go, into the jive. Looks like Mesnil's gonna lead.
Time on distance is good, and he's bow forward, so give the start to the French team. Egnot-Johnson went in for that last maneuver there. He didn't have to do that, and that dropped him back a little bit positionally, although he's got nice gauge.
Mensel and Egnot-Johnson, who's ahead? And coming down to the finish, looks like he's got a couple of boat lengths lead. Should be a comfortable victory here for Egnot-Johnson.
Woohoo!
Yet another victory.
Woohoo! Yeah!
Got it!
Kiwi!
Woo!
Bryce is trying to work his way to
where three matches are complete, two are pretty well spread out. We already have a lead established, so I'm ready for a joke. Anybody got any good jokes we can tell? Sue Ellen, have you got any jokes you can tell us? Kiwi jokes. Actually, we can't do any Kiwi jokes because this is a rated G broadcast. So Egnot-Johnson in control, leeward boat, pushing hard. Number 9 there in the Club 100 spinnaker. He doesn't want to get rolled. If he does, he's going to jive away. Here he goes. And that leaves Egnot-Johnson with no choice but to jive behind. Oh, bit of trouble on the jive there. What's going on? Spinnaker collapsed. That was an unforced error. Opening the door for Egnot-Johnson from behind the Audi spinnaker. Can he catch up? Can he get an overlap? Can we get a bit of a luffy battle going before the finish?
So Egnot-Johnson is the leeward boat. He's on starboard. Out to windward and just ahead of him is Bolden. Bolden's problem here is he can't jibe. If he jibes, he's going to interfere with Egnot-Johnson. He would get a penalty. This should be a win. They're coming down, trying to soak into the leeward end of the line.
The leeward end, the left-hand side, the pin. Egnot-Johnson, or Bolden rather, number 9, he needs a left-hand shift. He needs to be able to lay that mark, and I'm not so sure he's going to get it. Now, this is interesting. Egnot-Johnson goes for a final jibe. It's a right-hand shift. He's bow down on port, heading for the committee boat, end of the line. Now, he was bow behind as far as Bolden is concerned, but it's going to be bow to bow now. In fact, no. The Kiwis have done it. Coming from behind, I think Egnot-Johnson has got the race as he crosses the line. Look on the committee boat for the flag. If it's yellow, the race will go to Nick Egnot-Johnson. Holding our breath here, which one is it? Who's
yellow.
Got it? Yes, yellow. It's yellow. Egnot-Johnson, incredible race coming from behind just at the last second to take it.
Yeah, people always say football's a rough game, but you gotta give me a break. First of all, the game only lasts an hour, but each player only plays about 7 minutes. I saw some research on that, because if you're on offense, you're not playing when when their defense is on the field, and if you're a specialty kicker, you're only on there 3 or 4 times. So these sailors leave the dock at 10, 11 in the morning, and they're out here till 4 or 5 at night. And even when you're not sailing, you're out in the sun and whatnot. So sailors are much tougher than football players, and you got to give them a lot of respect for that. Hey, speaking of that, let's watch these boats come into the gate. Here's where the crew really takes over. You know, the jib's got to go up, the pole's got to come down, the spinnaker's got to come down. The boat that does it better has a big advantage, is the gate, which is fantastic for match racing because it gives the trailing boat the chance to split from the leading boat. So expect to see the trailing boat go to the opposite gate mark. That's an intentional tactic. to try and get some clear air. So Johnny Burson with a lead gets to choose which gate mark. There's no doubt he takes the right-hand mark looking upwind, because that allows him to go to the right. We've already determined that's the way to go. So the leader has the advantage of the gate to choose the mark he wants. The trailer goes the other one. And there's a little bit of hope in there. As Kenny Reed said, hope is not a strategy, but that's what you just saw there at the gate.
Looks like Egnot-Johnson doesn't have another jibe to get to the finish. Egnot-Johnson digging deep, coming down middle of the picture here.
All but over, into the finish. And not much left for Harry Price, the Stella Hardcross Spinnaker. The last match on the race course, the last win this afternoon here in Long Beach, day number one of the Congressional Cup, will go to Nick Egnot-Johnson from New Zealand over Australia's Harry Price. The last cheer, folks, let him hear you for those that are still here on the pier. Nick. And that's it. That wraps up day number one. We'd like to thank you for joining us here on the pier and, of course, live around the world online. This is just the start, folks. We've got a lot more to throw at you this week. We're going to be here through to the end Sunday. Who will be crowned the victor of the 55th Annual Congressional Cup? Well, Mark Townsend and Mary Cheers and I will be predicting that and actually delivering it to you by the end. Sunday afternoon, the party continues here on the Belmont Pier, but for right now, we're closed out. Join us tomorrow. Action continues here in Long Beach, 11:30 a.m., the start time. Thanks for joining us.
Yee-hoo! Oh, the Kiwis. All right, guys, you had a pretty good day, winning 5 from 6 races in the first round robin of the Congressional Cup. Sammy, just talk us through the hard part of today.
I suppose the hardest moments were in our race against Yonny Benson. The boats are really heavy, they're 5 and a bit tons, and it's really dangerous to get slow. And we allowed ourselves to get a little bit slow in the pre-start, and it never really was an opportunity to get back in front. Other than that, though, we had a pretty awesome day.
We were pretty stoked. Like, we, you know, we always back ourselves with our sailing, but you know, obviously it's a super tough regatta, and we've never really raced in a regatta with this caliber of sailors. But once we started getting a few wins on the board, yeah, we felt pretty good, and you know, we feel like we executed our process as well, which was our goal for the day. And every time we execute our process as well, the results can follow. So we were really, really happy.
All right. So yoga at 8 a.m.
Absolutely.
With your wellness coach?
Yeah, perfect. Cheers, Becca.
Looking forward to it. It's good for us.
Good work. All right, guys, well, best of luck for tomorrow. New Zealand is cheering for you. We're cheering from you from the pier. So, you know, make us proud.
Thank you, Sue. Cheers.
Good night. Sleep well. Lights out.
Will do.
Go to bed.
From there. This is my bed. Get out of my room.
Get out of your room.
Off my bed.
What about this section? Who's here, Timmy?
That's where his head goes.
Right, what about down here? Who goes here?
That's me. I'm a big lad, you know? Yeah.
You're a triangle, mate.
I take up a bit of room.
Do you snore?
Absolutely. Then why do you think I'm here?
And cut. Yeah, cut for the day. Cut. Cut.
You're still filming. You know,
heard Anakin.